YouBigNonce!
Well, hello, big nonces. It's me, dogbomb. It's Friday. That means it's time for an indie game review for YouBigNonce. And this week, I'm playing this game here. It's called Fobia or Fobia. I'm guessing Fobia because that's a real word. Fobia isn't. Check your dictionaries. It's spelled differently than that. It's got a PH, like phone or frog. In other words. Anyway, it's called Fobia, but it's just come on Steam a few days ago, about a week ago or something like that. And it's the first game that this guy's ever designed, and he did it with his wife, and he sent me the game, and I thought that was quite sweet that he did it with his wife. Let's see if it's about murdering each other. I'll just try a new game here. Not tried it before, it's brand new. There's a person. There's a tree, and there's a bird on the tree. Now the person has a big red coat on. Everything else appears to be in black and white. It reminds me of that game. There's a game that's all in black and white, and it's left to right side scroll like this. What's it called? What's that game called? Anybody know what that game's called? Anyone? I'm listening. I can't remember what it's called. It's about a little boy and he runs in the black and white world. Oh, what's it called? I'm just gonna keep running and fall down. Oh, I fell on some. I just thought that was grass down in that hole. I fell down it again. I was so excited that I couldn't remember what this black and white indie game was called. It's called Limbo. You remember Limbo? So I'm using the game controller, and it's A to jump, B to jump, Y to do nothing, and X to do nothing. So it's A and B to jump. Not at the same time. You can press B or A to jump. Slide down these hills like some sort of ninja, and it might look like it's distorted on your screen. It depends on what your quality of your YouTube video is like. Can I push this? Yes, I can. I knew I'd be able to. If ever there's a block in an indie game, it means you can push it. That's me tip. And always push it. Never ignore it and then go back for a later. You're wasting precious times. So lovely deer in the background there. Lovely parallax scrolling in the background. Parallax is when the different levels of the background move at different rates. That's a stick there that I've pushed. Oh, for fuck's sake. Fell down a pit. I wasn't expecting that. That was a tricksy move by the designer. Very tricksy move. Right. So it's going to break. When I get to about that point there, I did it, I jumped it. There's also a black and white game, or I think it's black and white, I can't remember. It's a wild style I played it called Cannibalt. Can't remember, have I ever reviewed Cannibalt? I got really a... That bird's just pecked me eyes out! I got really addicted to Cannibalt for a while. It was on the mobile phone and it was on PC and everything. It's one of them games where you just want to keep trying to go for fuck's sake, man. You just want to keep trying to go further and further. This game... is about Little Red Riding Hood. You can see that she's Little Red Riding Hood because she's little and she's wearing a red riding hood. How do I defeat this bird? How the fuck do I... Can I duck? Can you duck? You can't... So you can't... How? I don't know how I defeat this bird. You can't duck. You've got no guns. I tried jumping into its face there, but that just seemed to make me a tastier snack. A more readily available snack by jumping up into the bird's jaws. I'm jumping at the wrong point of this twig as well. That's annoying me. Right, here we go. I've got to listen for the... Oh, I thought I had to listen for the crack and then jump. It's a little bit faster than that. I'm not sure I like this puzzle. It's not really a puzzle. It's more of a memory game. Jump! Right, did it. More of a memory game. It should give you a little bit more time to jump when you hear the crack. How do I defeat this bird? Do I need to run back? Wow, you little fucking, it just fucking claws you in the face as well. It doesn't beat about the bush, doesn't tease you a little bit first, doesn't come down with a little cheery car, car, or anything like that. It's just like, fuck you, little girl, claws to the face. And you've got suddenly claws in your face. That's never a good... Keep running! Claws in the neck. Right, I genuinely don't really understand what I'm doing here, where I could be going wrong. So, I'm gonna just run across a bit. Maybe I need to run back and hide under that little cliff edge. Or maybe there's something I'm missing down. Aha! What the fuck? The fucking cliff edge grew fierce! You fucking mad bastard. Oh, wait. Come. Cliff edge, come with me. We can be like best mates. He looks like a right hard bastard as well. He's the sort of bloke who, if you're going out for a night out drinking, he's like your ugly mate, but he's got a good presence, if you know what I mean. When you walk into a club, he's got a good presence. Aha, seesaw. Now then. The old seesaw block puzzle. Isn't quite working how I expected it to. Hang on. Think I need to get on the other side of that block. And then push it on the seesaw. Is that right? Is that how weights and measures works? There we go. And then up. Good lad. Well worked out. Good physics work there. Good physics. I've had a bit of a cold this week. I don't know if that's coming through on my voice. Or if I'm coughing or spluttering or sneezing or any of that shit. Right, I've got... What have I got here? I've got a fucking trap. A fucking horrendous trap. That's what I've got there. Somebody's put a fucking rock on a twig and then thought, oh, look, a handy bridge. No, fuck you, little girl. Somebody's been in this forest trying to kill little girls. And that's wrong. Look at this. I've got a wheel with spikes on. You mentalist. You absolute mentalist. I'm sure I didn't touch any of them spikes because I'm a master gamer. But I'm sure if I did, they'd kill me in one instant. There was a fucking crow that clawed my eyes out, remember? This is not particularly a nice game. And there's a lot going on. I don't know if there's several... Whoa, there. Steady on. Little sled. I like this. I like a little sled. I'm not sure if there's... I probably should have used it as a boat. In hindsight. I'm not sure if... What's that? Weird. I'm not sure if... What was I saying? I'm not sure if... It's designed for little kids to play this game. Or if it's for adults. But I'd probably advise... It's more of an adult game. There's a lot of death happening. A lot of death. More death than I thought there would be, to be honest. But that's fine. I can cope with a little bit of death. One day I'm going to die, and that'll be a good laugh. My little girl there just basically gave up. She just put her hand up and was like, fucking hell, I've fallen in the water again. I am a witch. If I float, burn me. Right, hang on. That looks like a perfectly serviceable boat to me, but I think I need to jump across and then jump across again. Right, here we go. Bush. Bush. I'm on the log. I'm on the log. I'm on the log. Bush. I'm on a different log. Are you little bastard, yeah? You see, there's just tricky bits like that. I'm not expecting. Just hoise them in there. No fucking prior warning. Just comes right at you. Like, oh, for fuck's sake. There you go, hide that in there, and then wait for it to settle, wait for the boat to settle. Jump on the boat, get over the- Oh, you little fucking loggy bastard. This is frustrating me a little bit, because it seems quite twee, this game. You're probably sitting at home thinking, this seems quite twee. That bit where the croak picked his eyes out was quite la-di-da. But no, it's actually harder than it looks. Oh, you... Do I need to wait for the boat to bob? I think I need to wait for the boat to bob. I want to get past this bit before I fucking leave yous. Otherwise, cause this will piss me off all night. If I don't get this fucker sorted, it's going to really piss me off. Here we go, right, here we go, here we go, here we go. Steady on. Jump on it, wait for the boat to bob, wait for it to bob, settle down, and then whoop, onto the log, there you go. Good lad. Over that fucking dodgy trap. We've moved on, we're onto the next bit. Fucking barrel, fucking barrels, who the fuck do you think you are, Donkey Kong? Don't fucking put me back. Right, here we go, I'm still on the barrely bit. I need to jump over like fucking Mario. Like fucking Jumpman in Donkey Kong 1. Eh? There's a reference. For all you kids. Fucking Jumpman. I'm just showing me gaming credentials there by mentioning Jumpman. I'll say something. I fucking knew that was going to happen. I could see there was something on the floor. And then I stood on it. And then it definitely is some... cunt who's making track. I bet it's fucking Kevin McAllister. There's a bunny rabbit or something in the net in the back there as well. Right. There's a fucking leaf trap here. You bastard. I knew that was gonna... I don't even know why I stood on it. I stood on it to see what it would do. If anything. I was just tempting fate by standing on... Right, here we go. Jump over that cunt. Oh, yeah, I thought I could just jump it, but you can't. You've got to wait for the bastard. I thought I was being so clever by touching it. Just set it away like this one. You've got to set that one away, you see? And then you've got to jump it. Oh! I thought it was going to clamp me in the back of the head there. This one, just jump straight over it. Ignore it. You fucking wolfie! I think I need to run backwards and lure the wolf into the trap. Here we go. Here we go. Ready? Ready? Trigger this one. Wait for it. Now go for it. Jump. Get ready to lure the wolf. There's a sentence I never thought I'd be saying. Get ready to lure the wolf. Come on, you wolfy bastard. There you are. Come on. Ha ha ha, in your face. Ha ha, you guys give up. Are you ready for more? Thirsty for more. That's the quote. Don't misquote Home Alone, Dog Bomb. Don't misquote Home Alone. That's the one thing that I was always told by my grandfather before he passed away. Never misquote Home Alone. You filthy animal! For fuck's sake, run! Oh, I should have gone down in that. Oh, hang on, it didn't. It didn't kill us. I should have gone in that hole, though. I should have gone in that hole. Story of my life. That's going to be the title of my autobiography. I should have gone in that hole by Dogbomb. I jump over the first pit, fall into the second pit, just wait it out, and then allow it to fill the gap, and then you be the second one to fill that gap. That's the follow-up of my autobiography, the second one to fill that gap. My second autobiography. I'm planning on having at least 17 autobiographies. Much like Jordan. Right. Log. Jump off the... I got stuck in some sort of glitch there. That's the game cheating. Not me. That's the game cheating. I'm going to try once more, and then at my next death, I'm going to say goodbye to you all. I know I'm going to die at some point. I've no idea how long this game is. I can't even remember how much it is. I think it's about a fiver on... I'm going to play on past that bit, obviously. I think it's about a fiver on Steam. I'll post the link, as usual, below. Like I say, it's this guy's first game. He's called Eugene. I remember that from the email he sent me. And he developed it with his wife, so who can just imagine the sort of fun that they must get up to of an evening to consider this game about killing a small child in the woods. Fucking claws in the... I can't believe those claws in the eyes, honestly. Anyway, I'm going to, I can't fucking do that. I'm going to leave it there for this week. Leave you with the thoughts of a dead girl in a red dress at the bottom of a pit in the woods. Something for you to consider as I bid you all farewell for the week. I'll see you next week for another indie game review for YouBigNonce. Bye for now, BigNonces. Bye for now.